George is more focused on the ghost moth, so he headed out for the night to see how their moves compare.
In ordinary urban parks, amongst the swings and slides, peculiar wildlife spectacles are happening.
It may not look like the best place to see rare and unusual animal behaviour, but looks can be deceptive.
Stephen Cummings, a local wildlife filmmaker, is constantly on the search for rarely seen and secretive animals.
Well, if I wanted to see unusual animal behaviour, I wouldn't necessarily come to an urban park as a first choice.
It's funny you should mention that, because in another park, not too far from here, this is what we had.
Now, you and I know that that's caused by ermine moth.
The locals thought this was a scene out of a Hammer horror film, and, you know, they were so freaked out by it, they deserted the park.
A few weeks ago, Stephen got a call about another rare moth behaviour sighting in one of Yorkshire's parks.
This, like many municipal parks up until 5 years ago, they used to mow this on a regular basis, and there was nothing here. But since they stopped mowing it, it's perfect for things such as ghost moths. This is one of only two sites that I know of locally where you are likely to see the mating dance and mating displays of ghost moths. But if you want to see this spectacle, you've got to be here at night.
Well, that's something I have never seen before, so I'm going to be really pleased if we can see it. My goodness.
So to try and capture their spectacle for ourselves, we'll have to wait around until dark.
But I have to be honest, these are pretty small moths in a very large area. What we're going to need is lots of luck.
As night falls, ghostly figures begin to stir.
One there. There's a couple over there, I think. One over there. Okay, it's really starting now. Three now. Look at that, look at that. You can see them now, all over the place.
That's a lot.
I love that colour. They're just a ghostly, ghostly white colour. Fantastic. And I have to say the full name on camera because it's such a nice name. Hepialis humuli. Isn't that a great name? I mean, it's amazing that these things spend the majority of their life cycle underground as larvae eating roots, all for one glorious night. And they come out, they have this beautiful dance in the moonlight, they mate, and then it's all over.
Time is crucial for the males. They have no functional mouthparts to feed and only live for around a week. With time against them, they use pheromones and a pendulating dance with one goal in mind, attracting a mate as fast as possible.
Yes, it's a female. She's smaller than the male, and she's got these rather beautiful markings on the wings, which are themselves much darker than the male. There she is. This could be your big night. All she's got to do now is to find a male ghost moth, mate, and drop her eggs in the grassland. There you go.
And after another hour's searching, the wait really pays off.
Oh, wait, what's that? Oh!
Have you got a pair?
There it is. Oh. Well, this is it. This is the icing on the cake. The male's ghostly dance in the moonlight has worked and he's found a mate. I've never seen this before. And for me and for them, this has been an absolutely glorious night.
Well, it's proving to be a glorious night here as we are now joined by Anushka Shankar, one of the leading figures in world music.